Another hypothesis regarding the biological factors that play a role in schizophrenia is the dopamine hypothesis. This hypothesis suggests that schizophrenia involves excess dopamine activity. One reason this hypothesis came about was from the observation of individuals who overdose on major stimulants like methamphetamine and cocaine. These individuals, if you recall from our lesson on drugs, have similar behaviors and cognitions as those individuals with schizophrenia. Indeed, physicians have reported that it is difficult upon initial observation to determine whether somebody is schizophrenic or whether they are overdosing from a major stimulant. Another factor supporting the idea of the dopamine hypothesis in regards to schizophrenia was that drugs that block dopamine appeared to be effective in treating the positive symptoms of schizophrenia. However, there are some problems with the dopamine hypothesis, and we will discuss that further in our next lesson when we discuss treatments for mental disorders. Another neurotransmitter that does seem to play a role in schizophrenia is glutamate. It appears that glutamate deficiencies may also explain the symptoms of schizophrenia. That is, glutamate is important in learning, memory, neural processing, and brain development, and it allows us to make some stimuli more important than others. Therefore, glutamate is crucial to selective attention, such as focusing attention on some items of information while ignoring others, and it may explain why these individuals have difficulty with sustained attention, cognitive control, and working memory. Now let's go back to Lauren with the brain regions associated with schizophrenia.